Well, good morning, folks. Lester here. I hope you're off to a wonderful Sunday. Today, we're going to talk about something that's going to be quite controversial. And I'm actually excited about today's video because I'm going to be able to share a piece of my personal opinions. And I can't wait to read your opinions, even though I can already tell they're going to probably differ than mine. And that's okay. That's the beauty of our pages, is that we're allowed to have our opinions in an open discussion, a forum, if you will, where we can all say the way we feel. And based on our experiences, based on things we've heard or read or researched. But today we're talking about, I'm just going to say, being a man and what it means to be a man. And to a lot of ladies, this could also apply to you as well. I do think, however, though, that the things that attract a man to a woman may be different, probably just different than what attracts a woman to a man. So hear me out before you rush to any rash decisions. And let's have some fun with this, shall we? Let's have some fun. And no matter what you say, if you could find a way to say it in a respectful and tactful way, the fact that we can agree to disagree, it goes a long ways. I love you, and I really do hope you have a wonderful day. And at the end of this day, we may still disagree. But I'm sure Tex doesn't. Him and I, we're on the same page here. Oh boy, Lester has gone off and done it this time. Lester has gone off and done it this time. Friends, I want to talk to you for a second about, let's talk about something we can all agree on. Here we go. I'm going to name some movies, and you tell me what is synonymous about every one of these movies, and I'm going to remind you, they are movies that every one of us have seen, probably multiple times. Titanic. The Gladiator. Troy. Top Gun. Saving Private Ryan. Die Hard. Oh, my memory fades me. My memory fades me. The Patriot. So that's six, I think. That's six. But I can stop right there. I think that you know where I'm going with this. In every single one of those movies that have been watched by both men and women multiple times, there is one thing that is synonymous in every last one of them, is that there's a man, a character, and in that movie, he fights for a woman. Sometimes it's the odds are well stacked against him. Fight Club. Gosh, the movies are kind of just rolling now. There's so many. And I'm going to go ahead and say this, that most likely none of these movies that are in your top favorites are of the romance category. Instead, they're movies that both you and your husband have enjoyed. Your husband will watch them by himself. You'll watch them by yourself. Every time they come on and you see them, you can't help but watch them. And yet, you don't realize what you love so much about them. Because they do include that piece of romance. Romance being not lovey-dovey, kissy-huggy, cuddling, cuddle and affection. But instead, it shows a man that is willing to fight for what he believes in, which oftentimes is a woman who he believes in. That man is willing to put his life on the line for what he believes in. And in none of those movies, here we go, this is going to be the tough one. And in none of those movies do you have a man. Look, there's a car stop at our driveway. In none of those movies is there a man who walks around with his hands in his lap, who's yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am. Nope, not a one of them. Not a one of them. And so what I'm trying to say, what I'm trying to hypothesize, okay, I'm trying to hypothesize is that more times than not, women prefer that kind of a man. Now, that may not be your man. The man that you're partnered with right now may not be anything like the characters in those movies. But I can promise you one thing. Every man wants to be one of those kind of guys. And here it goes. Here it goes. This is the worst thing I'm going to say all day. I would bet that almost every woman wants to be with that kind of man. Like I said, it might not be who you're with, but it's who you fantasize with and who you dream about. That's why we love those kinds of movies. That's why we love to watch them over and over and over, because it takes ourselves away from our realities and puts us into a character that we either like to be or like to be with. You might be saying, so Lester, where are you going with all of this? Where, Lester, what are you doing? What are you trying to do? What are you trying to say? What I'm trying to say is that it is my opinion, and I bet it's one that is shared by a lot more people than you realize, that at some point you want a man to be a man. And what that means is there are characteristics of men that we find appealing, that we find attractive, and that this world demands and requires. There is going to come a day when we're going to wish we had more men like those we see in the movies. Men who will rush into burning buildings to save. Men who will rush into a firefight, either in wartime or as a police officer. Men who will put themselves into harm's way to save those they have sworn to protect and serve. And you know what? And of course I say men, you know what I mean, men and women, people. We want people. Oh, yesterday we talked about Waylon, our youngest future herd bull, and the fact that when a bull gets to a certain age, we have to allow our young men to grow up and become men. And the same way, at some point, we have to allow our young bulls to grow up and become herd bulls. And sometimes the idea of walking around with your hands in your lap doesn't really go hand in hand with growing up, preparing yourself for what the world needs more of. What I'm saying is true. You don't have to like it. You might have found yourself so caught up in some of the different movements where you have a hard time actually acknowledging that what I'm saying is true. But you probably won't feel that way next time you're caught in a burning building and you're wondering who will have the courage to rush in there to save you or your children or even your pets. You probably won't feel that way next time you have a loved one trapped in a active shooter situation and you're hoping that someone will have the guts and the courage to run in there and put themselves into harm's way. There's a whole lot about what we may not feel like we can still say, but that we know we still need in life. And what we need now, more than ever before, are those who are willing and able to get into the fight. There's an expression or a saying that goes something like this. Hard times create strong men. And then strong men create easier times. Easier times create weaker men. And then weak men, in fact, create hard times. Guys, I'm just going to say this, that my grandfather, now I'm only going to talk about the people who I can actually remember. My grandfather was as strong of a man. Both of my grandfathers were as strong of men as I've ever known. They were both exactly like I would say all of my characters in those movies were. That's how they acted. That's how they lived their lives. They would defend their children, defend their families, defend their homes, defend their women, defend their country. They would defend against evil at any cost. And so then I'll take the next generation, which is my dad. I'm not saying anything negative about that generation, but I see a lesser. You see a lesser generation. You see a lesser generation. And then, if you think I'm being mean, now let's talk about my generation. My generation isn't half the man that my dad's generation was. And it's nothing. It's non-comparable to what my grandpa's generation was. And I'm so sorry, son, to my sons, but their generation is even worse. Guys, I don't know where we're going. I don't know where we're headed. But there's one thing that I'm trying to make my point over here, is that on the farm, they don't belong to movements. On the farm, these animals don't jump in on what might be politically correct. They don't give a darn about the LGBTQ, WXYZ. They don't. They don't. A farm is as real as it gets, and it doesn't change with the eras. It doesn't change with the politics. It doesn't. That fella right there, he lives for his women, for his family. We even saw the night that Mr. Huck was attacked, how he would have gone out of his way to defend even his larger family in an entire different species, how upset he was with what was happening around him. And so when we sit here and we talk about let's love and coddle and let's just keep being affectionate towards our young men, meaning Waylon and Santoro, guys, in my opinion, you're wrong. In my opinion, it's my opinion that if we do that, we're in fact going to create nothing more than what we've created with our own children of today, a much weaker and lesser man. All right, so I'm going to say one last thing, and this might be something else that many will take offense to, but that's not my intention. I'm just calling out what I feel like are obvious facts, that there are some women who like the safe bet. You don't want the characters from the movies that I mentioned. You don't want those kind of characters to be your partners because they're unpredictable. They're dangerous. They're the kind who do put their life on the line. And you don't want that. You want the safe bet. You want the kind of man who will walk around with his hands in his lap, who will sit beside you at Sunday school. And all I'm trying to say is the farm doesn't act that way. Every one of these fellas want to grow up and be just like that one over there. That's their mentor. That's who they look to. And so what we do not do is put our hands on them once they pass a certain age. We don't want them to be sweet and kind and gentle and look for lovin's, as many of you said. They get their lovin' in the form of clean, fresh water. All of their nutritional needs are met, which includes vet care, minerals, and you name it, we try to provide proper farm management, which obviously we have struggled in that department. But what we don't do is try to pretend that these guys are of our generation with our mindset. The kind of mindset that has really taken our country and our world in a really rotten and lousy place. Now, you don't have to agree with me. I'm not going to expect you to agree with me. But I would love to hear your ideas and your conversations. I mean, this is a chance for you to talk and for me to listen. And at the end of the day, it may be that I do not agree with you. But it's my thoughts. And it's the way we run our farms, especially when it comes to our herd animals. So, all right, friends, are you ready? Are you ready? I do love you, and I'm blessed to have you. And if you feel like you just can no longer watch a page of a guy who does not believe in the modern day movements and the modern day way of thinking, well, I'm sorry you ever thought I was that guy. I am. I'm embarrassed that you ever thought I was that guy. I'm going to end this by saying one last thing. It's a simple thank you to all of the men and women who do live up to those characters we all admire so much. To those in the military, to those in EMS services, first responders, those who rush to danger instead of those who run from it, those who fight for what they believe in, they fight for a cause, those who fight for their families, their loved ones. And that's all we're trying to instill in our bulls. Thank y'all for watching. And hey, maybe we'll see you on tomorrow's video. Just maybe. We love you guys. We'll talk to you soon.
Don't let your troubles fester. Come watch Longhorn Lester.
Yeah, something like that.